Expansion of NSDL is National Securities Depository Limited. National Securities Depository Limited, this NSDL was established in 1996. So this NSDL is a one subsidiary of NSE, one subsidiary of NSE, National Stock Exchange. When Government of India passed Depositories Act, the Government of India passed Depositories Act in 1996, which was very much essential at that time for stock trading, stock activity, stock dealing. At that time, when everything was computerizing, all transactions, all this stock trading, stock transactions were completely, it was like transformation from traditional trading to the electronic trading system. At that time, Government of India passed an act called Depository Act in 1996. Then the NSE took an initiation, NSE, National Stock Exchange, took an initiation, and they started NSDL, established an NSDL in 1996, NSDL. And at present, NSDL has more operations, not only like mainly maintaining a dematerialized account. This NSDL also involving in new pension scheme opening account under the new pension scheme. Also NSDL involved in issuing a PAN number, permanent account number for tax purpose. So all these activities are done by NSDL at present. And not only this depositories work like maintaining a demat account, apart from that also these kind of activities are done by NSDL. And one more important thing we need to highlight, we need to know, we should concentrate here. This NSDL is the first depository of India. It is the first depository of India, where in 1996 NSDL started this. It means NSE started NSDL. That was the first depository in India. Till that moment, till that time, there was no any one, even single one depository. At present, there are only two depositories. One is NSDL and one is CDSL. CDSL is a Bombay Stock Exchange's subsidiary. NSDL is NSE subsidiary. This was the first stock exchange, first depository in India, which is a subsidiary of NSE. And there is also one more highlight we need to concentrate here. That is total average per day. It means in a day, 8,977 average number of accounts are opened per day. This is the one milestone of NSDL, where this many, nearly 9,000 or 9,000 plus now, nearly 9,000 number of accounts are opened per day. It's an average number. It's an average number. Nearly 9,000 accounts are opened per day. So that is also one milestone of NSDL. And it was, many students or many people will ask that why this NSDL was established. What is the purpose of establishing NSDL? What is the idea behind or purpose of establishing NSDL? To create one technical platform to trade and to settle the transactions and to maintain one standardized transaction platform or settlement platform to deliver the transaction, to settle the transaction, the standardized platform was required. Then NSE took an initiation and started NSDL. So it is established with an idea or with an intention or objective of providing a standardized infrastructure for national as well as international transactions. Then next is about shareholders of NSDL. You can see this, there are many shareholders under NSDL. Even Industrial Development Bank, IDBI Bank is also a shareholder of NSDL. Unit Trust of India, UTI, National Stock Exchange. National Stock Exchange is the main main shareholder of NSDL, because NSC is the parent company of NSDL. So NSDL is the subsidiary of NSC. So NSC is the parent company of NSDL. So National Stock Exchange has more number of percentage or more number of share at the NSDL. Then we have a State Bank of India. Then we have SBI, this State Bank of India, Global Trust Bank, Citibank, Standard Chartered Bank, many other banks. Not only these banks, even these are the high, it means high profile in the sense, these banks are having more number of shares, more number of holdings in NSDL, and even many more banks are also associated and also having shares invested in the NSDL's capital. Then this management of NSDL, how this the entire management of NSDL is implemented, how the company is trying to, it means NSDL is trying to manage its operation. So NSDL is managed by board of directors that to have as more professional knowledge, more professional ideas, more innovative things. Such kind of people are managing this NSDL. So NSDL board of directors, NSDL board of directors are appointed by NSE because NSE is the parent company. NSE will manage, NSE will try to appoint this professional board of directors as per the parent company. And in NSDL, to manage day-to-day activities, day-to-day operations, everyday's transactions, everyday's activities, there is a managing director. This managing director will take care about the day-to-day operations of the NSDL. Day-to-day operations of the NSDL are managed by managing director, and this managing director has few more people, few more members in the board to assist him. So to assist the managing director, there is a board of directors. 15 members of board of directors, executive committee is appointed to assist the managing director. Now we can also see this, how managing directors of NSDL is there. It means how the, what is the structure of management in the NSDL. Here this is the board of director details, board of directors. These are the details of board of directors. You can see here there are 7 members, mainly chairman, and he's also public director, public interest director. Chairman Mr. B.A. Prabhakar, chairman, former chairman of Andhra Bank, and now is the chairman of this NSDL. Then Nageshwar Rao. So these are the different people. He's the CEO and public director, interest director, public interest director, public interest director, shareholder director. See, there are main key, these are the 7 people are the key managing people. These are the 7 people are key managing people. This is the board of director details. And if you click on management, we'll come to know many things about the NSDL management. CEO is the managing director and CEO. Then executive director, vice president, executive vice president, all these people. You can see this, slowly you can go through this. Nageshwar Rao, Prashant, Sunil. So these are different vice president, senior vice president, executive vice president, senior vice president. So these all people are helping to managing director to undertake the day-to-day's activities, day-to-day's transactions. Day-to-day transaction means each and every transaction this managing director or CEO will not go through, that will not see. So it is like how this entire management is supporting the managing director. And these are the milestones. If you go through this, if you click on this milestones, every year wise they have given the details. In the year 1995, this is the starting NSDL incorporation. Actually, NSDL incorporation took an initiation in 1995 itself. Here, commencement of DMAT trading. So it was started work or dealing related to the DMAT account in 1996 itself. NSDL inauguration was in November 1996. Then in 2021, last, it means in this present year, what are the milestones? You can see here. Launch of digital commerce paper issuance process also implemented by NSDL at present. And also, if you click on many other aspects, if you click on this services, if you click on this, many other aspects, you will come to know many things which are related to the statistics. Even statistics are also available. See here, statistics, investor accounts, 2,25,09,000 change investors accounts are there under NSDL. And this is only with NSDL. There is also one more depository called CDSL in India. Okay, all this information is available in NSDL website.